Hello friends, welcome to the Industrial Automation channel. So in today's video I am going to show you how to connect PLC Delta PLC to Modbus Leo, any Modbus Leo simulator. So for this we need one Modbus simulator. So first we will download the simulator. Just check in this website. I will give the link in description. Okay. Select your operating system. I have 64-bit, so I am going to download 64-bit version. Just download this. Okay. So you just need to install this software. Okay, I have already installed this, so I will not install again, but you need to install that software. Okay. Now open WPAsoft. This is previous program. I will just close this. Create new project. Select your PLC model number. I have SE series, so I will select SE. Okay. Control S. I will just save the program. Modbus test. Okay. Now you can see here communication setup. This is communication program. Okay. Just click on this. We are going to use COM2 RS485. Select RS485. Next, we'll take it as a M1000, means always on bit. So these are the communications protocols. Okay, here you need to just click on hold communication setting. These are the parameter of RS485. So this 7-bit, I'm going to use 7-bit, even parity, stop bit 1-bit, and baud rate 9600. Okay, and we are going to use ASCII mode. This is 8-bit, and we will give the 200 millisecond. This is in millisecond. Okay, just configure these values, click next. We are going to use Modbus format, so check this second option. Next, don't do anything here. Okay, just click on finish. Okay, this is the Modbus program. Now all these program we need to first configure all Modbus parameters. So in this program all we have configured all parameters of Modbus. We'll just save this. Now we'll just write some code. LDM0 out Y0, means if M0 is on, then Y0 will be on. We'll download the program. PLC is connected through Ethernet, so I will just check it Ethernet. Click OK. Okay, we are downloading the programming PLC. Put it in run mode. Okay, now PLC is connected to laptop through USB port. Okay, so for Modbus you need to just need USB to 485 converter. Okay, I have connected USB to 485 connector and it is connected to the PLC. Now go to device manager. We'll check the port, COM port. okay, we have COM port 2. Here I have connected the USB to 485 module. You will easily get it in market. Now just open the software which we have installed previously, Modbus Pole. Okay, you can also use ModScan or any other simulator. I prefer this Modbus Pole which we have recently downloaded. Okay, just go to connection, click here connect, register letter. Okay, we are connected through serial port, so serial port selected. Here you can select the COM port. Okay, we have COM2, so COM2 selected. We have 9600 baud rate, 7 data bits, even parity, 1 stop bit. This is ASCII mode and response time 1000 ms. Okay, illegal data address. Now we'll just go in setup, rewrite definition. So first I will show you one address table. This is address table of Delta PLC addresses, and these are the Modbus addresses. I have differentiate all these. So for input, these addresses are used for inputs, these addresses are used for outputs, these addresses are for timer. You can see X0 is PLC address, and for Modbus address we need to use this address as Modbus. For output, for timer, and for memory bit, these are the addresses. M0 for PLC address and 2049 is Modbus address, so we will use these. I will share this sheet with you. In description I will give the link of Google Drive. You can download it from Google Drive. Okay, so first we will see the status of M0. What is the address of M0? Modbus address 2049. Okay, it is 002049, right? So we will select here 0x. This 0x means 00. Okay, 0x 2049. Okay, the PLC address is 20450. It is showing 50, so we will make it same. So just click on this PLC address. Okay, so 2049 is address of M0, and we will read our 10 quantity of data. M0, M1, M2, it's up to M9. We will read up to M9. So entered 10 here. If I entered 5 here, only 5 value will be readable. Just click on OK. Okay, now this is 2040, this is 2041, 2042, so like that. This is 2049. So we will just give the name this as a M0. This is just name. Okay, let's open the WPL soft. We'll just rearrange the window. Okay, now if I will click M0 on, set on, this gets 1, means this is the value of M0, right? If I will set off, this will be 0. Okay, we will take M1 also. I will show you M1. If M0 is on, set on. Now M0 is on and M1 is also on. Here you can see M0 is on and M1 is also on. Okay, so in this way we have read registers, that is memory bits. So now we will read output. Okay, so for output you can see what is the address for output. These are the outputs. Okay, starts from Y0, Y1, Y2 up to Y377, and same modbus address for this. For Y0 it's 001281, and same it's up to 1536. Now we will take Y0. So what is the address of Y0? 001281. The starting is from 00. Okay, remember this thing. So just go to setup, rewrite definition. It's already on 00. This is 0, right? Address is 1281. Just click on apply. Okay, here you can see this is address of Y0, this is address of Y1, this is address of Y2, this is just name. I'm giving the name Y4. Okay, we'll open the PC program. Okay, so now Y0 is on, that's why it's showing 1 here, correct? Now if it is off, now Y0 is off, now it's showing 0 here, perfect. Similarly, you can see the Y0, Y1 address here. Okay, this is of Y0. So for input, you just need to select here. For input, you need to select 1, because input address is 101025. So here, we will select 1. This is 1x. 1x means 1 series. So in 1 series, what is the address? 1025. Input address 1025. Just click on 1025, because this previous 10 is already here, we have selected here. So you need to just enter address of last 4 digits. Okay, apply. Okay, so this address will be for x0, this is for x1. We'll just check by forcing x0. We'll force on this. Okay, we have force on x0. You can see x0 is on here. If I remove force off, it will show 0 here. This is for input. Let's go for the register or timer. We will release the force. Okay, now for timer, you can see here there are 2 addresses I have shown in for timer. So these addresses are for bits and these addresses are for word. So why there are 2 addresses? For input and output there are only 1 addresses, but in timer, in this address, in word address, you will get the timer running value, means present value. Okay, that could be 1 2 3 4, like that. So this word is for timer value, timer current value, and these addresses will get on if your all time will be done. When your timer will be done, then this address will be turn on. This is bit type and this is word type. So let's see, I will show you the difference. Now first we will see the modbus word address, this address. Okay, so it's starting from 4. Let's select here 40. Let's select here 4. This is 4x, so select 4x. Now enter the address 1537. Okay, apply. Okay, so this value is for T0, present value. This is similarly T1 present value. Okay, in this way it's up to T255 and Modbus address is up to 401792. Okay, let's go to PLC side. We will just add one more run, LDM3 TMR T0 suppose K50 means 5 seconds. Okay, let's download this program. Now you can see right now it's zero value here, so let's on the timer, set on. The timer is increasing, you can see the value same here, increasing here, it's timer value. Okay, so we have set the 50, so up to 50 is incremented, and once the timer is done it will be stop. Okay, now we will see the T on bit. This Modbus simulator we are using, we have not activated it, so we are using trial version, so it will not run more than 10 minutes. So we'll just save this file on desktop, Delta Modbus. Okay, we'll just save this file, we'll close it and we'll reopen it. This is the file, we'll reopen it. Okay, now for timer done, we have the address 1537. We'll check with that. Just change here. Okay, first we'll turn off this, set off, go to setup, read write definition, no connection, first connect. We have already set all parameters, just click on OK. So it's connecting now. Go to setup, read write function. Okay, now we are going to read timer bit. So it's starting from 0. So we will select here 0x. Okay. And the address is 1537. Address is 1537. Just click apply. Okay. This is T0. Done bit. This is T1 done bit. Similarly, it's up to T255. Okay. Now this is 0, right? So it will be 1 when this timer will be on. So let's turn on this, set to on. So it's counting. Once it becomes 50, this will be on. Okay. Now the timer is done. T0 is on, so you can see here T0 is 1. If I will set off, then T0 will be again either here 0, the bit is 0, means T0 is off. Okay, now I will show you data registers. Okay, so here I will just add one more run, LDM 1000 move. Suppose K10, we will move K10 into D0. Suppose we will take D5 now. Click OK. We will download this. So what is the Modbus address for D5? Let's check it here. These are the data registers. Okay, for D5 we have the value 404102. Let's go to Modbus settings, setup, read write definition. So now it's starting from 40. Okay, and it's register, so you need to select read holding registers 4x. Okay, and what is the value ahead of 4? We are using D5, so we will take 4102. Just enter here 4102. Okay, you can see 10 value is here. this is d5 value, this is d6 value. You can see in d5 10 value is there, so it's showing 10 here. We'll add one more. We'll move a20 in d6. Now d6 is showing 0 here. Once I download this, it will show 20 here. You see in d5 10 value is there and in d6 20 is there. Okay, in this way you can check all your Modbus addresses. You can read all your PLC addresses, inputs, outputs, timers, counters in any Modbus slave device. Okay, I have used here Modbus fold device, but you can use Modscan also, or whichever your favorite. Okay, so this sheet is important. I have mapped this all addresses. I am giving the link in description to download this sheet. I will put it on Google Drive. Okay, thank you friends. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.